wasted too much.
I got another battery.
Oh. Rough.
Woo!
the sights come right through here.
Pass them out.
More trash. Now you're a guy.
And now you're an act guy.
I'll clean it up later. What the hell?
Throw in the trash. I'll clean it up later.
I think I'm gonna trade Dr. Spotberg again.
What?
Trade our doctor in.
You gotta highlight your film with little acts like that.
He's gonna go in a bodybuilding contest next year.
Go to Lisa's out! Who knows? We'll see it next time.
Ran out already, sorry.
Who was that, you
know? Gotta get those things out here racing down the side. Beep, beep, beep.
Well, how you doing?
Everybody's out here, huh?
Seems like, yeah. Well, Larry Jones is here every year.
Is that who that was?
Yeah.
I thought he was on a float earlier.
He's usually in them black and white men together.
Yeah, right.
Oh, God.
Now, there's a little extra something for your film.
What?
Get her a little extra something for your film. That'll give a little class to it. He wants to keep it straight.
Thank you.
shit.
Crazy party here. I'm not even out of my chair. Bah, humbug.
Oh, Channel 7?
Yeah, no.
It was on up to the expo next month. Well,
this was pretty nice.
Looking very nice.
Up and down the whole coast.
Are you?
The whole month, yeah.
Driving?
You didn't drive this thing, did you?
No, that's rented.
You rented this?
I rented it.
I noticed.
Well, no, well, we live downtown.
Oh, so you have.
We live on Jefferson Park.
Much better river.
We don't get juices at all.
And when you do, you're going to have to pay for parking for the tickets.
It costs $95 a day to park. And $95
a day. A day?
$95 a day.
Why are they going up?
Yeah, no, I know. That's I only live three blocks. I moved. I used to live 6 blocks. I moved just about a month ago. That's the right.
That's the right. That's
the But if you know the neighborhood, you can always find parking. Go around once or twice.
Yeah.
So, even get this on the side. This
convex lens is pointing a different way than when you're shooting it. In other words, you can point it over here and be shooting them all down here, up and down, and they won't even know what they're doing.
I wonder how it's going to turn out as far as print and, you know, energy and stuff like that. But in reality, I'm going to check it out.
It would be nice.
Each one day and just have a field day.
Just looking at everything. Oh, now can cool for a second. This is great.
I would say probably in a year's time we rented like 10 times. Maybe a dozen.
What? Did you rent this inside today? Just for coming here?
Yeah.
I take Park public Street, public Street public bus.
I will not take public
transit. So you just rented it from going here to here and that's it?
Hey, next year you invite me over for brunch, I'll turn around and I'll drive you up here.
Yeah, brunch here.
I just can't stand crowds up anymore. I don't know what the fuck it is. I just can't handle crowds.
Well, I can't either, but I, you know.
I'm starting to get used to it. I have to.
Oh, it is nice now.
It is.
He bitches at me for wearing a t-shirt.
No, but just what? If I don't wear a shirt like this, I just do like this, like...
No, a lot of times I'll wear a t-shirt in this weather too, because I swear a lot. I don't know why.
Yeah, a lot of t-shirt going to soak it up, right?
Sure, one more.
I find if it's not up here, pure cotton, and I'll swear it back to it.
What the Indian thing the other day, it feels, and I roll the sleeves up because it comes down like here. This will wear it out. I don't feel for wearing it out. I don't know why I took the air conditioner out. I probably ran there and get cooled down from it.
If you're warm, we can go in there and get cooled down from it.
No, that was cold.
I said, you'll get cold.
Watch out!
Watch out.
Oh, he's a downer.
Yeah, usually I march in the second where it's done.
Yeah, we like following.
Terrible. No shit. He sees him with real bad. He sees him with real bad. I'm just getting over it. I'm not myself yet.
I would say so. I'd be embarrassed. Look at that gorgeous thing. Come on, next to
me. No, this is your
five minutes of gay stuff. What an answer. What a fucking answer. What a comeback answer. That's true.
The last one should be a big, huge shower truck. A water truck. A huge,
really? That would be great.
Now we'll turn the car shoes. This is longer than last year, isn't it?
That's right, yeah.
You get, do you?
Why don't you?
She can't stand it. What is this?
Is it that or a song, I think?
Let's hurry it up.
Look at this sucker coming down the street.
She's gonna be so high to walk down the street like that.
Just the way they should all be. Get some speakers in there and blast the suckers. Hey, I could advertise free washroom here. We could get lucky on this one yet. Talk about
custom van with a TV antenna in front. Now we are talking. Madison's the best one I've seen for a long time. Noisy and colorful, two lanes down the street.
Come on! psyched up there.
I'm getting some good shots.
For sale, $1,500. Here, he doesn't even have his own motor either. That's extra.
God, look at this.
Dogs, you bark at him.
Are you shooting it?
Every day.
Get stuff under the car?
Oh, yeah. Just get in the window, would you please?
Because if you notice, because we're part of this country, we're part of the world. That's in the new bar of Madison.
You can sit on our shoulders if you want.
We also have in our audience today, I'm not sure if they're in the front, they're back. The National Gay Olympics are going to be taking place this coming August in San Francisco. And we have a lot of the people that are going are right here. Gay and Lesbian Athletic Community on Gay Games 2, August 9th through 17th. Of course, to be represented in men's volleyball, women's softball,
when
men's
go to San Francisco?
Wrestling, racquetball,
7th,
track and field, triathlon, swimming
the
and diving
first of August,
and marathon.
We're going to
we have a banner up here. These are some of the people going representing Chicago. Let's give a big hand to Team Chicago. Morning, as many people from the gay community as possible at City Hall, okay? They did it in New York. There's no reason why we can't do it here. That's July 9th, 6 to 8 a.m. at City Hall.
girls going to see me. Oh,
sir.
Thank you for all your support for all the choruses. Next coming on stage is one of my favorite groups, good friends of all of us here in the city, the only women's chorus in the Midwest, the Art of a Singer, under the direction of Susan Schlate.
Don't knock it over.
Sorry.
Yes, we are.
They didn't knock it over, did they?
Thank you.
for the Pride Parade?
Here you go.
Okay, we're going to have a brief break for a minute.
1986 to be Mattachine Midwest Day in Chicago. And I urge all interested citizens to be cognizant of the significance of that day. Culminate on June 29th with the 5th annual Proud to Run race, the 17th annual Gay and Lesbian Pride Parade, and a combined rally and music fest in Lincoln Park, bringing together an estimated 50,000 Chicago residents. 50,000 Chicago voters. Now there's 50,000 Chicago voters. Now, therefore, I, Harold Washington, Mayor of the City of Chicago, do proclaim June 20th through 29th to be Gay and Lesbian Pride Week in Chicago, and further proclaim June 29th to be Gay and Lesbian Pride Parade Day in Chicago, and urge all interested citizens to be kind.
Officially called Catherine Margaret Bridget Duffy. I want to thank Kit for her wonderful introduction. And I want to thank her for just being a wonderful, wonderful helpmate over the past 3 years and being a liaison to the gay and lesbian community for this administration. She's done a marvelous job of keeping us abreast of the matters going on. She's kept me informed constantly of the concerns of the gay and lesbian community. And the net result is that our administration clearly knows much more and can do much more about the question of gay and lesbian rights.
Where are you going? When I go back, I don't see why not.
Thanks.
You're the first one to ask, so.
How long have you been today?
I don't know. Maybe 15 minutes.
Okay, thanks. I'm right up here.
Okay.
Certain members have slipped down surreptitiously like thieves in the night to Springfield, and have tried to undo our fine work, and have tried to take your product away from you. Let me suggest this to you. Tonight, every one of you should call your state senator, every one of you, call the governor, and tell him one thing, and that is this. These parks belong to the people of the city of Chicago, and keep your cotton-picking hands off of them. Now, you know I love to orate, but today I'm here on serious business. And so consequently, I'm going to read a very brief statement. And the reason I'm going to read it is because I want everyone to understand thoroughly the position of our administration on the matter of gay and lesbian rights. I don't want any confusion about it. And so therefore, it has been written down. It says, this administration, notwithstanding the fact that much, much more has to be done and will be done, has made good strides in fighting discrimination against gay and lesbian people. We will continue to do that while also focusing our attention on AIDS as a major public health problem. Discrimination against gay and lesbian people is a civil rights issue, just as discrimination on the basis of race, religion, or national origin has always been a civil rights issue. And as a black man, and who comes from a race of people who have suffered atrociously from discrimination, I am not about to permit discrimination against anybody in this city as long as I'm the mayor of this great city. Oppression, suffering various forms of discrimination based on affectional sexual preferences. This is wrong and violates their civil rights. These wrongs must be punished. We've taken a number of steps to eliminate discrimination on the basis of sexual orientation. One, we have included language barring such discrimination in recently negotiated labor contracts involving city workers. Two, we have strengthened the language and enforcement of the current executive order barring discrimination in city employment based on sexual orientation. This is to ensure that all of these steps constitute a good start, but they're not enough, and we know it. We must do more. We will do more. So I have added my support to the ordinance currently pending in the City Council that would extend protection to gay and lesbian people under existing laws. This ordinance would prohibit discrimination in housing, employment, and public accommodation. This ordinance is scheduled to come up to vote in the City Council on Wednesday, July 9th. I urge all those present today to let your alderman know how you feel about this ordinance. Write them, phone them, call them, send them a message any way you choose. Make your opinions known and come to the council session on July 9th to further show your backing for this ordinance. In the near future regarding the problem of AIDS as a major menace to public health. Sometime in July, this coming July, I will be receiving a report containing a series of recommendations from the Committee on Gay and Lesbian Issues on how we must deal with the problem of AIDS and implement it to the fullest extent of our personnel and resources And although they're not as vast as we think or want them to be, they are awesome in their scope. I have received some preliminaries eradicated. This is a continuing fight, just as the fight against racism and sexism is a continuing one. But you know me, I keep my word. When I came into office, I said, for example, oh yes I do, oh yeah. There were three Eddies, and now there are none. The females holding. Not 15, not 20, not 25, not 30, not 35, not 40. 39%! Yeah. I keep my word. I keep my word. It's fair. It's free. I'm an affairist.
Change into things as we are. Oh, it's all to give. Let it arise. Just arise. soon.
Los Angeles. Especially for me, I feel like I'm bringing home my latest home to my dad. We brought a little bit of Southern California with us today.
Bob?
Shirley Temple, Jeremy Semple is equally understood. Go out and try your luck, we might be Donald Duck. Hooray for Hollywood, hooray for Hollywood. In Valley, hooey Hollywood, Hollywood, where any office boy or young mechanic can be a panic.
That we're here in Chicago this week. We are sharing the stage on Tuesday evening with the Chicago Gay Men's Chorus at Orchestra Hall. Buy tickets.
I started from Denver Bowers, full of flowers bloom in the sun. Every morning, and Donnie Birdie sing and everything a sun.
City Singers for being here from Milwaukee. We're very proud of you. I want to thank Artemis Singers, of course. Windy City Gay Chorus. Gay Men's Chorus of LA. And of course, the Chicago Gay Men's Chorus. This year, they decided to take a vacation. They went to Florida. They raised money for AIDS in Florida on vacation and started another men's chorus. The South Florida concert, South Florida Gay Men's Chorus, have 125 members. They gave their first performance just a couple weeks ago. These guys never stop giving for the cause of AIDS. I'm proud to present Chicago Gay Men.
Chicago!